Hi guys, welcome back to Hamdi's Diary. If you are new here, you are welcome. You are welcome to Hamdi's Diary. Check out other videos and I'm sure you will love them. Remember to give them a thumbs up if you enjoy watching them and subscribe to Hamdi's Diary. From the title, you know we are talking about sex. Someone is like, hey, Hamdi, I can't talk. Well, so let's go on. Sex is our topic, as I said. Sex is a gift from God that is supposed to be opened in marriage. But contrary to that, sex has become an object of recreation, adventure, and even for commercial purposes. Some even think, everyone is doing it, so why don't I do it too? There is also this erroneous concept that when you are at a certain age and you have not had sex before, you are not well balanced upstairs. But that is just the devil's own way of enticing young, vulnerable people into this sinful act. Whether for spiritual, religious, or common sense reasons, there are 1,001 reasons why you need to stay away from premarital sex. So let's go on and talk about some of the reasons why you need to stay away from premarital sex. Most people who engage in premarital sex end up with a great sense of regret. They might not say it out openly, but deep down inside their hearts, the question they are asking themselves is this all that sex is about? By then too, it would have been too late. You would have already cheapened yourself to an undeserving person. These days, people give out sex for all kinds of things, for jobs, for money, and all kinds of materialistic things. Some people even think giving out sex to a man will make the person marry you. You are joking, girl. He won't marry you. So when the person ends up not marrying you, you go around on the internet disturbing the peace of people. All men are good. All men are scum. No, girl, they are not all goats. The fact that you're cheapening yourself to one goat doesn't mean they are all goats. There are good men out there. They ain't all good. Fear. There is always this fear and emotional instability that comes after having unprotected sex, especially for women. Men actually don't really have that problem. Like, after sex, they just forget about it. It's like they've achieved their goal and they just move on with life. That's why sometimes you come to a man that you are pregnant, like, how did it happen? Why did you get pregnant? But yeah, it's actually that the woman that is left with this temporary fear until she menstruates. So the moment it delays for one day, fire is on the mountain. She's panicking and she's worried, am I pregnant? If you stay away from premarital sex, you would have no cause to worry, even if your menses delayed for more than a week. In fact, even if you are worried, you will not be worried about pregnancy. It will be for other things. So save yourself this unnecessary fear and panic. Unwanted pregnancy. As a young guy, as a young lady who is starting life, who is probably under somebody's care, you should not have any business doing with premarital sex. Like, stay away from it and focus on other things, better things in life. I once met this lady in the hospital and the nurses were insulting her. They were just insulting her and she was crying. Do you know why she was crying? This lady, I think she felt feverish and she came to the hospital only to find out that she's pregnant, and she was acting surprised. Even me, I was annoyed. I was like, ah, so you had unprotected sex and you are crying, like you are surprised you are pregnant. What are you thinking? Is there any special water you drink to become pregnant? You have had unprotected sex and you are scared of getting pregnant. Like, even people have protected sex and they get pregnant. Now you, that there was no barrier. Like, I was so annoyed. The way I was eyeing the lady. Reduced performance. Engaging in premarital sex is a distraction that can make you unable to deliver your best no matter where you find yourself. The psychological effect associated with indulging in premarital sex can make you unable to concentrate. If you are a student, it will make you perform poor. If you don't take care, if you are working too for someone, Instead of you to focus and on the work that your boss has given you, you are probably thinking and praying your wife does not, your girlfriend does not call you to tell you that I miss my period, and you are in constant fear and panic. Why are you worrying yourself instead of you to focus on better things? Contracting of diseases. These days, sexually transmitted diseases like HIV, gonorrhea have become like football jersey. Too common. You look here, there is AIDS. You look here, there is gonorrhea. You look here, there is this. All over. If you don't take care, just one try and you will be unlucky and you just get HIV. So the best thing you can do for yourself is to abstain. Abstain. And these days, too, people don't really care about pregnancy anymore because they feel there are condoms or I can just take some contraceptive pills. But they forget that these contraceptive pills have short and long-term effects. You might not see it today. It is later in life when you have repented. That is when you will start seeing the effect of these pills that you took. By then, you would have married one innocent person's child, and you are hoping that the person will forgive you or the person will live with you just as you are. Please stop it so that you can save yourself from all this trouble and save the person that will marry you later in life. Negative effect on future marriage. There is the tendency to compare the sexual performance of your previous partner or partners to your partner when you marry. And this can lead to dissatisfaction that can cause misunderstanding, adultery, and even end up in a divorce. Also, sex before marriage makes you selfish. Marriage is about serving each other and pleasing each other. But then sex before marriage is about just pleasing oneself and enjoying oneself. So when you eventually marry someone that you've been having premarital sex with, you might not have that same urge. And this can lead to serious problems. Loss of respect. There is always loss of respect for both the man and the woman, but it's mostly the women that suffer it the most. How many women will go and sit among their friends and go and say that, oh, this guy, I had sex with him. Like, there's no pride in it. It's the men that take pride in it, which I don't know why, but then they sit among their friends and they're like, oh, this lady, I claim. Don't allow yourself to lose your value that way. Don't cheapen yourself to any man. Close your laps and keep your dignity. Sex often masks problems. Evaluating your relationship is not something you are likely to do when you are already having sex with your partner. Are you compatible? What are this person's interests? Do you see a future with this person? Important questions you should be asking. But you will not allow yourself to ask this question because you are already having sex with this person. The problem with this is that these things don't go away. They always find their way back after marriage. Less pain in case of a breakup. Breakup on its own can be difficult, but it can be exceptionally traumatizing when you have already given in sex, especially for the women. It's mostly women that suffer the most, so please, lady, stay away from premarital sex. Yes, you might cry, you might sulk and all, but in the end, once you have not had sex with this person, it will be able to just pick up yourself, to just pack your things and move on. So please, stay away from premarital sex. Okay guys, this is where we come to the end of this video. So what do you think? Yes, I might be here sharing knowledge with you, but I am also on the journey. So share with me your thoughts. I love to read them. If you enjoyed watching this video, give the video a thumbs up, share with anybody that you think will benefit from it, and subscribe to Hamdi's Diary if you have not done that yet. I will see you next week, but until then, take good care of yourself and be nice to everyone.